Hi everyone. It's another, it's another part of the year, the second quarter. Okay, this is gonna be your second quarter for love. Okay, I'm gonna put down the link for your January, February, March, which I did already. It's the first quarter of the year for love, and now we are almost half of the year, which is crazy. In April, May, June. So this reading is gonna be for your second quarter of the year. For love, okay? And also, I just want to let you guys know that I'll put the link, yes, for the January, February, March. It's down there, which we uploaded January. And also, there's also a year prediction of love. Isn't this interesting? I'm saging. But yeah, so I'm doing this in a very different manner. I'm mixing astrology because astrology is part of it. But I have houses that that I will draw. These are cards of astrology for the houses, which will help you. The goal is focusing on that particular house. Again, this is related to astrology and numerology because it means whatever card I draw here, it's meant for you to focus on. Okay, and I'm also gonna use the court cards over here, which represents, okay, so this represents the heart, okay? So it's very different. The house is the heart, and then this represents the mind, okay? And I'm gonna be using a soul card, which I don't have here, but the soul card will be here. So basically, mind, heart, and spirit, okay, in one, okay? To focus on this second quarter of the year. I'm so lost. I shouldn't do this without even a script. But yeah, so, and then I'm gonna be using the chrysalis for the tarot. Okay, wow, I'm just like a magician. Oh, now it didn't work. So yeah, I'm doing the chrysalis for the tarot where it will show, okay, how to go about it with love, okay? So focus on the houses, focus on the mind, focus on the soul, and then the tarot will guide you on, you know, like things to be seen, okay, to be expected. Okay, so with that being said, here we go for all the signs. Hi Cancer, welcome to my channel, I'm Sal. We're doing your love second quarter for this year, okay? Of course, what year could it be? Okay, now I already laid out the card, I already shuffled it, and now let's go into your reading. Okay, the first is the mind, okay? Your main focus are, you know, in the next 3 months is Knight of Coins, okay? Very, I know this is a love reading, but influential. Money is connected, finances is connected to you manifesting love. Single couple, okay? So, Knight is about, you know, this energy is willing, okay, to ride through it, okay? That's how I feel it. It's like, finances is always at the back of your focus. As far as love, it's always connected to you, okay? And how you charge towards it is like you bring this with you. Your work, your career, you bring this with you with love, single or in a relationship. The house that it is calling for or needs to be focused on to help you is the third house, okay? The third house here is like your potential to learn something and, and your local neighborhood as far as energy, okay? So it is about further studies, which is very interesting because I'm not sure why, but this is the, you know, like in synchronicity, this is what a house that you need to help and focus on. I'm feeling that with regards to your finances, single couple, okay, it's about learning. Okay, that's the main key point. Understanding that, the house is calling for you to learn and understand and further through it. Okay, so accept that, you know, like this is always going to be part of you. And you always need, you know, in the next 3 months is that further understanding of your finances, basically, I know, right? Is connected to your love, single or in a relationship. Strongly, I feel finances is right now the focus of your energy. Now, I only should draw one soul card, but you guys got two. So I'm seeing here, okay. This is again your pentacles being controlled, your money being the focus, and here, okay. It is very divinely guided, so don't doubt. Okay, if you're manifesting love, don't doubt that your finances will be like, whoa, no. Look at this. You're doing the work. And someone out there is making sure you put in the work, we give you everything that you need, Cancer. And your hands, look at these hands. These hands are very blessed with energy. So whatever you touch in it, because you guys encompass, you know, like, I mean, very strong energy of love and care. All you do is about love and care. There is no doubt the divine will give you anything that you would need to manifest love, single or in a relationship. It's very, like, your hand is basically like, it's not made of gold, like, you know, other signs would be, but your hands is like a healing hand, okay? A loving hand, that's what you have. And look at this, the star. Singles, I wouldn't say this, but yes, the promise in the horizon for Cancer for a soulmate is there, it's evident. The universe, again, look at this, the synchronicity of here, handing it towards you. Amazing. And look at how this is being celebrated by all these energies coming and receiving the energy of the divine. Amazing. Eight of stones over here. Again, I'm like I told you, you guys are working hard. This is the foundation. And look at that. You are creating, okay, a manifestation that will go towards beyond time. If this is what I'm saying, if this is the Stonehenge, it stood time. The relationship that you have right now, couples, will stood time. The soulmate that you are about to meet, Cancer, will stood time. Amazing, because the foundation of your coins is being laid down. Without further understanding the stability of finances, of controlling your money, okay, the union will not survive, okay? People don't understand this, but again, this is a special part, I guess, for you guys. In order for you to manifest love, finances in an earthly way has to be stable. You cannot have love only. It has to have finances. It's very nice how this is very focused on money, because it is a really good, it is really a foundation. I'm not gonna lie. I may read a lot of love, but again, finances is always a strong foundation so that the relationship will, you know, it's one thing less, you know, it's another thing less to think about. There. Now you understand, Cancer. Sorry, I was babbling. One thing less to think about. So I wish you guys well in the next 3 months. And I'll see you guys again in June. Link down below. Okay, if you guys want personal reading. Have a wonderful second quarter, guys. Bye.